Good afternoon, children. Our subject for today is English 2, Module 1 of 3rd grading. We will be learning about predicting outcomes. Now, let's begin. What's my target? At the end of this module, you are expected to use clues to answer, clarify understanding and predictions before and after reading. What am I good at? Look at each picture. Color the star that tells what will happen next. Number 1. Look at this picture. Do you think she will sing a song? She will cook? She will go to sleep? What is the correct answer? Very good. The correct answer is she will cook. Number 2. The girl will go to school. The girl will swim at the pool. The girl will go to the party. Correct answer is the girl will go to school. How about number 3? Look at this picture. What do you think will happen next? The dog will sleep. The dog will wag its tail. The dog will bark at the thief. Very good. The answer is the dog will bark at the thief. Okay, what's to look back? What do you think will the children do? And what do you think will happen to the seeds? So the answer is very good. What do you think will the children do? Of course, the children will plant the seeds. How about second question? What do you think will happen to the seeds? The seeds they plant will grow and would bear fruits. Next, what will I do? Look at the picture again. What animals do you see? You may write your answer in your paper. Now let us read the short story about Proud Frog. And after reading this story, I want you to tell what happened to the proud frog. Now let's read. The Proud Frog. A little frog saw a big fish. The proud frog shook his head. "I can be bigger than that fish," he said. He puffed himself with air. More air, puff, puff. More air until he became so big. He could not breathe anymore. Now what do you think will happen to the little frog? Here are the choices. A. The frog will get smaller. B. The frog will be glad. C. The frog's body will burst. You may draw your answer inside the box. Now, what did you apply from the activities? We learn about predictions. What is prediction? Prediction is telling what will happen next. To predict, we look for clues. Clues can be pictures or text. Then, we use what we already know. Clues help us make a good guess. We make prediction. Number one, before reading, we think about the title and pictures. Number two, during reading, we stop and predict what will happen. Then number three, after reading, we confirm or adjust our prediction. That's how we predict. Let's move on to what's more to do. Tell what will happen next. Draw a line to connect the ideas. Let us read first. Number one, the sky is dark. Number two, Ryan eats a lot. Number three, the pupils study their lesson well. Number four, children keep their toys in proper places. I will give you 10 seconds to answer this activity. Okay, time's up. Let us check your answer. Number one, the sky is dark. Very good. Correct. Number two, Ryan eats a lot. Very good. Number three, the pupils study their lesson well. Correct. Number four, children keep their toys in proper places. Very good. Go to activity number two. Read each story. Choose what may likely to happen. Write only the letter of your answer. One, Anjo woke up with a grin. The sun was shining. It was a great day to the beach. After a while, A. Anjo jumped out of bed. B. Anjo rolled over and went back to sleep. C. Anjo studied his lessons. The answer is very good. In number one, letter A. Anjo jumped out of bed. Next, number two, Annie knew a storm coming. The sky was gray. A strong wind began to blow. Thunder rolled. Annie A. went out and played. B. stayed home with her family. C. bought burger for a snack. What do you think is the correct answer? Very good. The correct answer is letter B. Annie stayed home with her family. Next, number three. Pia was ready for dance show. She had done her steps over and over. She felt sure of herself. She smiled as she goes to the stage. A. Pia did the dance well. B. Pia forgot her dance steps. C. Pia did not join the dance show. The answer will be A. Letter A. Pia did the dance well. Number 4. The teacher plays a shelf in the room. She plays varied books for her pupils. A. The pupils will tear the books. B. The pupils will read the books. C. The pupils will play near the shelf. What is the correct answer? Very good. The correct answer in number 4 is letter B. The pupils will read the books. Number 5. Mrs. Ruiz placed the class rules on the board. The children read the rules. What will happen next? A. The children stared at the rules. B. The children followed the class rules. Letter C. The children did not follow the class rules. Okay, the answer in number 5 is letter B. The children follow the class rules. What did I get? Predicting outcome is telling what will happen next. You can predict outcome by looking for clues in the story. And clues can be pictures or words. And using what we already know. So that's how we predict outcome. Now what can I show? What do you think will happen next? A. The girl will finish cleaning the house. B. The girl will sleep all day. C. The girl will mess the house.
Okay, the answer is A. The girl will finish cleaning the house.
Next, how's my target? Guess what will happen next? Write the letter of the correct answer. Number 1. John brushes his teeth 3 times a day. He visits his dentist every year.
A. He has to eat a lot of candies. B. He has healthy teeth and gums. C. He has a tooth decay. The answer will be letter B. Very good. He has healthy teeth and gums. Number 2. Angel studies her lessons every day. She is happy to take her test. She finishes her test on time. A. She passed her test. B. She failed her test. C. She dropped her test. What do you think is the correct answer? Correct. The answer is letter A. She passed her test. Number 3. Lenny arranged her things. She left her book on the table. Her teacher asked her to bring it. Letter A. She felt happy. Letter B. She felt angry. Letter C. She felt shy. The correct answer is letter A. She felt happy. Number 4. Shane cleans her garden. She waters the plants every morning. Letter A. Her garden is beautiful. Letter B. Her plants look dry. Letter C. Her garden is gone. The correct answer is letter A. Her garden is beautiful. Number 5. Tess brought a tray of eggs. She passed by a group of friends. They are playing a ball. The ball hit the tray. Letter A. The eggs were safe. Letter B. The eggs were broken. Letter C. The eggs were cooked. The correct answer is letter B. The eggs were broken. Very good. Now, this is your offline activity. You will answer this in your house.
What else can I do? You will encircle the letter of the correct outcome. come. Number 1. Joel jumped out of bed. He looked at the clock. "Oh, I'm late," he said. He dressed up as fast as he could. He took his cap and basketball. He went out of the house. Letter A. Joel was late for church. Letter B. Joel was going to watch a basketball game. Letter C. Joel was going to play basketball. Number 2. Dandy knew that they will have a math quiz. He did not review for the test. He watched TV until midnight. Letter A. Dandy forgot to turn off the TV. B. Dandy failed the math test. Letter C. Dandy's classmates came to see him. That is your offline activity. You may write your answer in your paper. Okay?
That's all, kids. Thank you for listening.